In this video lecture, we are going to talk about Ratan Tata. Ratan Tata is a prose prescribed for BCom Part 3 Semester 5 in compulsory English textbook. This is a prose. In this prose, we read about Ratan Tata's biography and his achievements and the economic contribution he made for the development of Indian industry. Ratan Tata, he born in 1937. He is grandson of Jamshedji Tata. Jamshedji Tata is well known personality. He is founder of Tata Group of Industries. His father, I mean Ratan Tata's father, was adopted by Jamshedji Tata's younger son having the same name Ratan and his wife Nawaji Bai. Then Ratan Tata's parents separated in 1940 when Ratan was 7 years old. Ratan Tata and his brother Jimmy were brought up by their grandmother Lady Nawaji Bai. Let's understand the family tree of Jamshedji Tata. Jamshedji Tata is the founder of Tata Group of Industries. And he had a younger son. The name of the younger son was Ratan Tata, having the same name as the present Ratan Tata. Ratan Tata, the son of Jamshedji Tata and his wife Nawaji Bai, they were childless. This couple was childless couple. Therefore, they adopted a boy from a distant relative. The name of the boy was Naval Tata. Naval Tata is the adopted son of the younger son of Jamshedji Tata, Ratan Tata, his name, and his wife Nawaji Bai. Then Naval Tata, he got married and then he had two sons. The elder was Ratan Tata, the present Ratan Tata about whom we are reading in the text, and his brother Jimmy Tata. These were two brothers. So the Ratan Tata and the grandfather Ratan Tata and the present Ratan Tata have the same name. The grandfather and grandson grandfather and the grandson, both of them have the same name. And Nawaji Bai is the grandmother of present Ratan Tata and his brother Jimmy Tata. Hope that you understood the family tree. Let's start by reading Ratan Tata's schooling, which schools he attended, how he has got his education. So he attended the Champion School in Bombay and the Bishop Cotton School in Shimla. He finished his secondary education at the Cathedral and John Cannon School, Bombay. Once he was invited to speak at the school at Bombay, he delivered a speech as a special invitee, and in the speech he said, I quote, One thing I have never recovered from is a fear of public speaking. The only people speaking publicly in school were those reading out the sermon at assembly and those participating in debates. I wasn't among either, nor was I into too many extracurricular activities, in that I missed the full culture of cathedral, and it's my loss. Cathedral for me was a mixed bag. I particularly remember a mathematics teacher who I felt was determined that I never complete school. He almost succeeded. So in this speech, Ratan Tata is speaking about his school days. In those days, he had fear of public speaking. So he also says that at that time, when he was in school, he didn't participate in extracurricular activities. So indirectly, he is suggesting the students who are learning in school and colleges to develop stage courage, to develop skill of public speaking, and he also indirectly recommends to participate in extracurricular activities which are conducted in the colleges. The assignments which are given to Ratan Tata, let's go to the previous slide once again. And then after schooling, he completed his bachelor's degree in architecture with structural engineering from Cornell University in 1959, and he did advanced management program course of Harvard Business School in 1975. So he was an engineer, and he did engineering in architecture and structural engineering, and he did one advanced management program from Harvard Business School in 1975. After the school and college education, after the school and bachelor's degree, he was given assignment. He was not given a very good cabin, well-furnished cabin with all the facilities, with AC and all that. But his first assignment was a challenge for him. In 1961, he was assigned to Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited, TISCO. Now it is called Tata Steel, the flagship company of Tata's. There in the company, initially at Jamshedpur, he worked shoveling limestone and handling the blast furnace like common workers. From this we understand the culture of Tata Group of Industries. Unless going through all the experiences of working from low level to the high level, the Tata Group of Industries never assigned big roles, never gave deciding roles. So therefore Ratan has to go through all the experiences of working in the factories. Then during 6 years at Jamshedpur factory, he learned technical aspects of company's products and the corporate values of Tata Group. In 1968, Ratan Tata was given senior position after experience, and he was given charge of two Sikh companies. Sikh companies in the sense, these two companies were running in loss. So these two companies were the National Radio and Electronics Company Limited, NELCO, and Central India Textile. These two companies were running in loss, and Ratan Tata was given the charge of these two companies. Ratan Tata worked very hard and he turned around both the companies from loss to profit. From this we understand Ratan Tata's hard work. Then there was a problem in his life. In 1982, his mother was diagnosed with terminal cancer. He immediately flew with her to New York for the treatment. He spent there 4 months with his mother till she lost her life. In these 4 months, on one hand, he was taking care of his mother, and on the other hand, he was brooding, he was thinking and examining that in the world of business, there are many changes going on. Then he came to know that there is stiff competition in all the spheres of business, in all the areas of business. He sensed consumer revolution. Consumer needs were changing. Consumer needs were changing, he observed, and then he thought to turn Tata Group into diversified group of companies. Then in 1983, he devised a plan. He called it Tata Strategic Plan. As per this plan, he diversified Tata Group of industries by introducing contemporary business such as telecommunication, software, biotechnology, etc. And in 1991, when RJD Tata got confirmed that Ratan is the right person for the chairmanship of Tata Group of Industries, he declared Ratan Tata as his successor and the chairman of Tata Group of Industries. Then Ratan Tata faced many problems, many conflicts and opposition from senior managers. But through his hard work and commitment, he accepted all the challenges and overcome all the challenges. And at last, through innovation and efficiency of work, he became successful. He started turning India-centric companies to global business. What he did for this? The first step he took is of acquisitions. Tata Tea acquired Tate Lee, one of the largest tea companies in the world. Tata Steel acquired the Corus Group, an Anglo-Dutch steel and aluminium producer. Tata Motors acquired Jaguar Land Rover, which produces the Jaguar Land Rover cars. These are the three important acquisitions he made in his career, and all these acquisitions proved very fruitful and very profitable. Then he started indigenous Indian car production. We all know Nano car. It was brought into the market in 2008. Then he started software companies like Tata Consultancy Services. And as a result of this production, we find that the revenue of Tata Group of Industries increased a lot, and the Tata Group of Companies became one of the leading company in the whole world. And he has faced many challenges in his life. There was disagreement with senior managers, with workers' unions, but through his hard work and very nice planning, he overcome all the problems. Tata fought and won every battle of his life, and he got retired from executive responsibilities on 28th December 2012. But he came back as interim chairman in 2016-17 as Cyrus Mistry was removed. Cyrus Mistry was selected as the chairman, but there was some problem with Cyrus Mistry. Therefore, he was removed from Tata Group of Industries. Later, Natarajan Chandrasekaran took the responsibility as chairman and Ratan Tata retired from chairmanship. His commitment is very important. Commitment not only for the business, but commitment for the society also. He is a member of the Prime Minister's Council on Trade and Industry, the advisor board of the RAND Center for Asia-Pacific Policy. He has also been on the international advisory boards of multinational corporations such as Mitsubishi, the American International Group and JP Morgan Chase, among others. Government of India awarded Ratan Tata Padma Bhushan in 2000 and the Padma Vibhushan in 2008. These two are the highest civilian awards of India. His achievements have also been recognized by the governments of France, Japan, Singapore, Italy, and the United Kingdom through knighthoods and medals of merit. We should know his ethics and philosophy of life. That is very important. The first thing is that Ratan Tata lives a very, very simple life. He has repeatedly stressed the need for a level playing field. He says, "My dream India is where every Indian has an equal opportunity to shine on merit. In a country like ours, you have to try to live and lead by example, not flaunt your wealth and prominence." He is known for his views on ethics and high standards and encourages the youth of the country to think of themselves as Indian first instead of prioritizing local, state or religious affiliations. So here the prose comes to an end. I stop.